Hello and welcome to Affinity. Here's a pretty rubbish picture which I just took out of the window of a car. I have no idea why I took it, but let's see what we can do with it. So, first of all, what can we do? Let's do a little bit of cloning, and I'll just do a fairly destructive clone just to get rid of these smudgy bits from the windscreen. I'll go over there, Alt-click over here, and paint over that just to make that go away. That'll do. That's just sort of like tidy that up a little bit. So we'll do a crop and just get rid of that bottom bit. Keep that tree in on the right. That looks nice. And we'll leave the sky. That's it. So we're about a third and two thirds. So if you've got two thirds, you want to do something with it. So let's have a look at curves first. Look, there's all this dead space down here, which is why it's so dull looking. So I'll move up this up a bit, which will improve the blacks. And maybe put a bit of an S curve on it to pick up the contrast. There. Still not very great, is it? Okay, so what we're going to do then, and here comes the magic, out with the magic wand, is gradient map. Crikey, now that's a bit funny, isn't it? So let's start adding colors here. What we're doing, this goes from black to white, so we're going to kind of recolor everything. And where the light colors, they're in the sky, so we can do stuff in the sky. So let's start up there, and we'll start with a kind of pale yellow. We don't go completely white. Then we'll click on here to create another one, and we'll make that more like a real yellow. And we can click on the bit down here and then do final adjustments up there to what we want. That's great. Then I'll do a red. And red in there. I'll just keep the primary colours like that. And then I'll do a purple. And with purple, darkish purple around about here. I'll turn the red and blue down a bit because I've got a fairly darkish purple there. What have I got? I've got a green there. Well, let's make that just a little bit darker green, say. Maybe that can be useful down here. And that one here at the other end, we'll make that black. Now we've got a bit more of the makings of an interesting picture. We've got this bit up here, so how do we get rid of that? We just play around with the sliders. So if I move the purple down, it's going to intrude into that bit. Oops, gone a bit far there. Maybe what we need is another black here. So I'm going to click on that and hit copy. And that's going to bring this up a bit. It's looking a bit funny, isn't it? So I'm going to turn down the opacity just to make this a bit more realistic. Here we go. So it's not quite so exaggerated. I could also play with blend mode, so I'll just leave it on normal for now, so all the colors here are completely artificial. Then I can play around with this sky. See, if I move the yellow up, it's gonna constrain, so that sort of really dim yellow is gonna be sort of like maybe where the sun is behind there. Then I can bring the red up, so that's gonna sort of constrain where that yellow goes, so I can just do that a bit. Bit of purple there. Maybe let's put a copy purple, so we've got more of a purple zone. There we go. So that puts a bit of dark along there. Makes the red a little bit more sort of exciting. Sometimes you have too much of something, it's not that exciting. And the green kind of looks a bit of artificial here. So let's try, if I pull that off, that's no green. Just go back, drop it back on again. So just holding down the mouse button, off, on, off, on. Yeah, too artificial, isn't it? So I'll just pull that off. Maybe bump up the black zone down here, which is darkening everything at the bottom here, because we've just got a medium opacity. So how about that? Look what we've done. We've gone from, with just a couple of changes, from that to that. Yeah. Or if we do this with the history thing, we go from there to there. Quite an exciting kind of sky there, and you can do this. And this is just completely with recoloring, and it shows the power of the gradient map. and we can take a rubbish picture and turn it into something and go, wow, what an amazing sky. You're lucky to see that one. Don't tell them. Anyway, thank you very much for watching.